at the time of death between 8 and 12 hours ago. There's no visible cause, no sign of battery or assault. All we have is this. Can we turn her over? Karen Swanson. Is that a positive ID? She used to go to school with my son. Is that the case of 89, Detective? This happening again, isn't it? We see you've been working with us for just over 2 years.
Yes, sir.
You went to medical school, but you chose not to practice. How come you work for the ESPN?
Well, sir, I was recruited out of medical school. My parents thought it was an act of hormones, but I think it was because of my intuition.
Are you familiar with the agent named Fox Mulder?
Yes, I am.
How so?
By reputation, he's an Oxford-educated parapsychologist who wrote a monograph on serial killers and the occult that helped catch Monty Python in 1989, generally thought of as the best analyst in the ESP section. He had a nickname at the Academy, Spooky Smolder.
What I'll tell you is that Agent Mulder developed an addiction to an unassigned project outside of the Barrow mainstream. Are you familiar with the so-called ESP-Files?
I believe they have to do with unexplained phenomena.
More or less, the reason you're here. Agent Scully, we want you to assist Mulder on the ESP-Files. We'll also write debriefings on your activities, about you, about your observations, and the validity of your work.
Am I to understand you want me to debunk the ESP-Files, sir?
Agent Scully, we'll trust you'll complete the proper basic research. We'll want to contact Agent Mulder shortly. We'll look forward to seeing you.
Sorry, nobody down here but the ESP's most unwanted.
Agent Dana Scully, I've been assigned to work with you.
Well, isn't it nice to be so suddenly highly regarded? So who'd you tick off to have to be stuck with this detail?
I'm actually looking forward to working with you. I've heard a lot about you.
Oh, is that so? I was under a perceptual scent that you were here to spy on me.
If you have any doubts about my qualifications or credentials...
No. I have it all here. You're a clinical psychologist. You wrote the SQ3R method. You did your undergraduate degree in parapsychology. Skinner's Box, a new interpretation. Dana Scully's senior thesis. Well, that's a credential.
Did you bother to read it?
Actually, I did. And you know what? I liked it. It's just that in most of my work, the law of psychophysics rarely seems to apply. Maybe you can explain this to me. Female, age 21, no explainable cause of death. Autopsy showed nothing. Zip. There are also these two unidentified marks. But since you're a doctor, Dana Scully, maybe you can tell me what these marks are.
Needle punctures, maybe? Animal bites? Electrocution of some kind?
Oh, but how's your chemistry? These were the compounds found in the surrounding tissue. Any ideas?
It's organic, some kind of synthetic protein.
Look, I don't know chemistry, so it all beats me.
Do you have a theory?
I have plenty of theories. Maybe what you can explain to me is why it's bureau policy to label these cases as unexplained phenomena and ignore them.
Tell me, Scully, do you believe in the existence of extraterrestrials?
Logically, I'd have to say no. Like, given the distances required to travel from the Earth to space.
Conventional wisdom! You know what? She was the fourth of her class to die of unexplained phenomena.
Well, she died somehow. Like, if she was murdered, maybe it was just a sloppy investigation. Like, the answers are out there. You just have to know what to perceive.
Perceive? That's exactly it. That's the P in ESP! Oh my god, lost myself there. Sorry. See you tomorrow, Scully, bright and early.
You didn't mention yesterday. This case has already been investigated.
Yeah, the ESPN got involved after the first three deaths, when local authorities failed to turn up any evidence. Thankfully, the cases got reclassified and buried in the ESP-Files, where I later dug them up.
And you found something they didn't?
Mm-hmm.
The autopsy reports of the last three victims showed no unidentified marks or lesions, but they were signed by a different medical examiner than the latest one.
That's pretty good, Scully.
Better than you expected or better than you hoped?
Well, I'll let you know after we get past the easy part.
And the medical examiner is a suspect?
We don't know that yet. My straws!
What happened? What was that about?
Oh, you know. Probably nothing.
Agent Mulder, John Amber, County Coroner's Office.
Yeah. Hi. This is my man, Bud. And this is Agent Scully.
Hi.
Were you able to arrange for an examination facility?
I think we got something for you.
Ooh.
Teresa! Get back in the car! Let me handle this! I just want to talk to them! Excuse me!
I'm sorry, you are?
I'm Jay Amber. I'm County Medical Examiner.
Oh. Well, surely you've been given our informed consent.
No, we've been away.
Well, that answers that question. You know, why you hadn't done the MRI on Karen Swenson.
If you're making an accusation, you better have something to back it up with.
You like my man bun? Matches yours. Also, that guy, Jay Amber, he obviously needs a longer vacation.
Grace Holmes was the third victim. He spent time in state-mandated counseling psychology for night terrors after graduation.
Soames actually confessed to the first two murders, but he wasn't arrested because he never had any evidence to show that he actually committed the crimes. Did you happen to read the cause of death in the case study?
Exposure. His body was found in the woods.
Missing for only 7 hours. Well, it's pretty safe to say Ray Soames never made the ESPN varsity basketball team. Well, hey. Close this. Make sure nobody sees this or touches this. Nobody. Okay.
Wow, this is amazing, Scully.
Corpse is 156 centimeters in length, roughly 52 pounds. Corpse is in advanced stages of decay. Distinguishing features include lack of cerebellum and iris and retina, indicating that this is not human. Could you point that away for me, please?
This is too much for me to parallel process. If this is inhuman, what is it?
It's mammalian, so my guess is a chimpanzee.
A chimpanzee in the city cemetery and race on his grave? Try going out to their family. Oh, and a CAT scan and fMRI. And also, like, the blood type and a full genetic workup and the debriefing.
You're serious?
Well, we can't get here. Well, where to go?
laboratory inspection of the body and x-ray analysis confirms the lack of the thalamus at the top of the brainstem, although he does not have the medulla at the base. It also confirms the lack of irises, retinas, and yet an unusually large occipital lobe. One can only wonder the state of consciousness the victim had at the time of the crime.
Who is it?
Oral dinner?
Hey! I'm way too wired. I'm going for a run. You wanna come?
Pass.
You figure out what happened to the body?
No. And I'm not losing any sleep over it. Good night.
Help you. Oh, my son.
Ray, someone was a patient of mine, yes. I oversaw his treatment for over a year. For night terrors and schizophrenia. Ray had the inability to grasp reality. He seemed to suffer from some kind of post-traumatic stress.
Is that something you've seen before?
In similar cases, yes.
Billy! Billy! You've treated a patient named Billy!
I'm treating Billy, other Amber, and Peggy O'Dell. All of them have been long-term patients. Live-in patients.
We're trying to find a correlation between these deaths. Have you treated any of them with hypnosis?
No, I did not.
They're here in this hospital?
That's right. Going on for 4 years.
Would we be able to talk to them?
Well, that might be difficult. Certainly, in Billy's case. Billy's experiencing what we call a waking coma. Functionally, his brain waves are flat and he's persistent vegetative.
How did that happen?
Both he and Peggy were involved in a car accident out on the state road. Peggy?
Aphasia.
Peggy, you have some visitors. Would you like to talk to them for a moment?
No, Billy needs me to read to him now.
Peggy, does Billy like it when you read to him?
Billy needs me close.
Doctor, I was wondering if we can do an EEG on Peggy.
No, you may not.
Wait, that kid, what's his name, Billy? He wants to apologize. He didn't get to say goodbye. I'm reading his mind.
How'd you know that girl was gonna have the marks?
I don't know, a lucky guess. Clairvoyance, extra sensory perception much?
That's a pesh molder. What's going on? How do you know about the marks? What are they?
Why? Right here, little field report? I think you know exactly what I think.
I'm here to solve this case. I want the truth!
The truth? I think those kids were abducted.
By who?
By what?
You don't really believe that, do you?
Do you have a better explanation?
I mean, I'll buy that that girl has some kind of pronounced psychosis, but to say they've been riding around in flying saucers, it's crazy, Mulder. It's
crazy. First of all, I didn't say that, and second of all, no!
It's crazy. There's nothing to support that.
Nothing scientific, you mean? Don't put words in my mouth, Scully.
There's gotta be something! You had 4 victims, and they were all found in or near the woods. Karen Spunson's body was found in the forest. What's going on? How'd she get there? What were they doing in the forest?
I don't know.
With the county sheriff's department. You're trespassing on private property.
We're conducting an investigation.
Get in your car and leave, both of you, or I'll have you arrested. I don't care who you are.
What was he doing out there all by himself?
I want to come back here.
903, sorry.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm just...
What are you looking for? What happened?
We lost power!
My car isn't starting!
Ah!
We lost what?
We lost 9 minutes. Look, when I first looked at my clock in the car, it was 9:03. And I just looked and it just turned 9:13. That's 9 minutes. Look, look. Alien abductees, UFO sighters, they all say the same thing. They all experience unexplained time loss.
Come on.
And just like that.
You're hallucinating. Time just can't disappear. You're saying we lost time. It's a universal invariant.
Not in this zip code.
Agent Mulder's insistence of time loss due to unknown forces cannot be validated or substantiated by this witness.
Great. What? I want you to look at something.
Come in.
Go. What are they? Mulder, what are they?
They're mosquito bites. You're shaking. Come on, let's sit down.
I was 12 when it happened. My sister was 8. She just disappeared out of her bed one night. Just gone. Vanished. No note, no phone call, no evidence of anything. Now I have insomnia and dream of her disappearance every night.
You never found her?
No, and it tore the family apart. No one would talk about it unless under hypnosis. There were no facts to confirm, nothing to offer any hope.
What did you do?
Eventually, I went off to school in England. I came back, got recruited by the Bureau. Seems I have a natural aptitude for applying behaviorism and parapsychology to criminal cases. My success allowed me a certain freedom to pursue my own interests. That's when I came across the ESP-Files.
By accident?
At first it looked like a garbage dump. The kind of stuff that most people laugh at is just being ridiculous. But I was fascinated. I read all of the case studies. All of them that I could get my hands on. Hundreds of them! I read everything I could about paranormal phenomena, about parapsychology, about the occult, and...
There's classified information you've been trying to get at, but someone's been blocking your attempts to access it?
I don't understand who. Is it someone at a higher level of power? Look, I'm telling you this, Scully, because you need to know. Because of what you've seen. In my basic research, I've worked very closely with a man named Dr. Heitz Werber, and he's taken me through deep regression hypnosis. I've been able to go into my own repressed memories to the night my sister disappeared. I can recall a bright light outside and the presence in the room. I was paralyzed, unable to respond to my sister's call for help. Listen to me, Scully. This thing exists.
But how do you know?
The government knows about it. And I know. I have to know what they're protecting. Nothing else matters to me. And I've never gotten this close.
Jeez.
God, who is this? Hello? Who is this? Okay. I'll tell her. They just said Peggy O'Dell's dead.
The girl in the wheelchair?
I don't know. Hey, what happened?
She ran right in front of me.
She was running? On foot? Well, that's just...
We need to ask you a few questions.
No. Let's go. There's nothing for us here. We're going back to the hotel.
What?
Whoa, I did not say come in. This is the house of the ESP's most unwanted.
My name is Teresa Amber. You've got to protect me.
Come with us.
Do you consent to us interviewing you for our case study?
I guess so. That's just the way it happens. I don't know how I get out there. I just randomly get out into the middle of the woods. I don't think I have amnesia. I just don't know.
How long has this been happening?
Since the summer we graduated, it happens to my friends too. I'm scared I might die, like the others, like Peggy did tonight.
You know, Father knows this is happening, doesn't he?
Yes, but he told me not to tell anyone about any of it.
Why?
He wants to protect me. He thinks he can protect me. I don't think he can, though.
Do you have the marks, Teresa?
Yes. I'm going to die, aren't I? I'm going to be next.
No, you're not gonna die.
And Mulder, stay away from my Billy boy!
Billy's your boy?! Ah!
What's going on here?
Doctor?
Oh, sorry.
I think I know who did it. I think I know who killed Karen Swinson, and no, it wasn't my man boss.
The detective?
I don't know. Who the fuck is Connor? Billy Other Amber.
The boy in the hospital? The vegetable Billy Other Amber?
I know it sounds crazy, but Scully, listen to me. Peggy O'Dell was bound to a wheelchair when she ran in front of a truck. I'm not making this up. It all fits the profile of an alien abduction.
This fits a profile? Do you want me to read your mind?
Yes, read my mind. Peggy O'Dell was killed in the 9 minutes we lost on the highway.
You think something happened in that 9 minutes? That time, as we know it, just stopped? That something took control over it?
You think that I'm crazy?
What? Peggy O'Dell's watch stopped a few minutes after 9. I made note of it when we saw the body. This isn't hindsight bias.
That's it. That's the reason the children go out to the forest. That's the reason all of this was happening. Oh my god. The marks! The marks are from testing! The forest summons them out there, and they test on them. This all explains the genetic mutations we've been seeing, like in the body we dug up.
Well, and then the force! It summoned Teresa's body out into the woods tonight.
Yes, but it was Billy Other Amber who takes them out to the forest, summoned by alien impulses. That's right, that's it. Let's go!
Now, we could stand until the second coming, waiting for Billy to get out of his bed, but that's not gonna happen. He blinks and I know about it.
You notice nothing unusual? Do you remember what happened last night around, say, 9 o'clock?
I don't have short-term memory loss.
You're sure?
Let's see. I was watching TV, yeah.
Oh, you don't happen to remember what you were watching, do you?
Sorry, I don't recall.
And you also don't happen to know who was watching Peggy O'Dell last night, do you?
Not me. That's not my ward. That's not my aisle in the produce section!
Thank you for your time, ma'am.
Okay.
Good day.
Mulder!
Oh, Scully, what's up?
I can't believe this. That kid killed Peggy O'Dell.
Scully.
It's crazy. He was in the woods.
You're sure? Alright. But I want you to understand what it is you're saying.
You said it yourself.
Yeah, but you have to write the field report.
What's up? The detective's here.
Ah! You wanna listen? I told you to get out of this.
Ah!
Hold it! Hold it right there. You've got no business out here.
There were screams! Billy, you've known it all along.
Ah!
He's gonna kill her.
Billy, no! Leave her alone!
Dad?
Teresa! Scully?
Billy. Oh, God.
Scully!
Did you see?
What?
It was incredible.
What was? They're reuniting?
Yeah.
Yes, I saw it. It was.
If you can hear me, raise your right hand. We're going to use retrieval to get some sensory memories from you, Billy. Can you tell me about the light? When did you first see the light?
In the forest. We were in the forest having a party.
What were you celebrating?
Graduation. And then the light came.
It took me away to the testing place.
I would wait for their orders.
Billy, who gave the orders?
The light. They said it would be okay. No one would know. But the test didn't work. They wanted everything destroyed. They said they were leaving. I'm afraid they're coming back.
Don't be afraid, Billy. We're going to help.
What we've just witnessed, what we read through the briefings, the experiment's basis and credibility just seem wholly unsupportable. You're aware of that.
Yes, sir. My reports are personal and subjective. I don't think I've gone so far as to draw any hypothesis from what I've seen.
Or haven't seen seems to be the case. So, this time loss, did you or did you not experience it?
I can't substantiate it, no.
What exactly can you substantiate? Agent Scully, I see no evidence that justifies the legitimacy of these investigations, all these illusionary correlations.
There were, of course, crimes committed.
But, yes. But how do you prosecute a case like this? With testimony of their hypnosis using priming from a boy that claims to have been giving orders from an alien force through an implant in his nose? Even if there was no source amnesia, you still have no physical evidence. What, Agent Mulder, what are his thoughts?
Agent Mulder believes we are not alone.
Thank you, Agent Sully. That'll be all.
Hello? Banana! Hello? Scully?
It's me. I haven't been able to sleep. Insomnia. There's no case file on Billy Other Amber. The paperwork we filed is gone. We need to talk.
Tomorrow, I can use your mind.